And joining us now to talk more about vaccines and the coronavirus pandemic is Dr. Glenn Goldis. He is the chief medical officer at Kern Medical. Dr. Goldis, as always, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you. Good morning.
I want to talk a little bit about where we are right now. Of course, we are still in the purple tier. We should say that although the good news is that cases, hospitalizations, all of those numbers continue to decline, they are getting lower. They're just not low enough yet to move into less restrictive tiers. Do you think we're close, though?
Well, I think we're getting there. We're just beyond the point where we were at the peak of the summer cases. And so I'm glad to see that we're dipping just below that. Hopefully it will continue and we'll be able to open up more very soon.
Now that the weather is starting to improve, we're seeing some gorgeous days. More people are, it's actually inviting people to go outside and enjoy the outdoors. Do you still have to wear a mask, though, if you go out to, say, the park or if you're just going out and about taking a walk with friends? Do you still need to wear a mask or is it okay to remove your mask even if you're outside?
Well, certainly if you're outside, ventilation is ideal, but it's still recommended that you wear a mask. Unfortunately, the bulk of the U.S. population is still not immune. We still have challenges with getting the population vaccinated. And so it's still a good idea to practice distancing, masking, and sanitizing.
If there is proper ventilation, can you stay around someone at a closer distance than the 6 feet that we've been hearing about for so long? How important is ventilation?
Well, it is important. And of course, it's a multivariable sort of thing where it depends how good the cross ventilation is in any given room or area, how quickly the air is exchanged every hour in that space. And of course, what about the virus itself? It's a pretty small particle, only about 0.1 microns, but it's typically enveloped by some fluid or secretion. And most HEPA filters are rated at 0.3 microns. So it's important to make sure that you're in a well-ventilated space that's also properly filtered. And of course, depending upon how far away you are and how big the particles are will help to determine infectivity rates.
So that's definitely why it's important to spend as much time outdoors. If you can move something outdoors, that's better than keeping it indoors, right?
Correct. And of course, there are lots of restaurants that have those plastic flaps in an outdoor space, which of course hamper circulation and might be a problem. So just be wary of those locations.
Ventilation is key. I want to talk about herd immunity. We're hearing a lot about that lately. We're coming up on a year of this, and it seems like for a majority of the year, every single day there was some discouraging news. And now it seems like over the last several days and weeks, we're hearing more encouraging signs that we could be ending the most severe part of this pandemic at least sometime soon. That's why we're hearing a lot about herd immunity as more people become vaccinated. What does herd immunity look like? And is this something that we could achieve in just a couple of months? Or do you think it's going to take a little longer?
Well, I do think it's going to take a bit longer. You really need 70 to 85% of the population immune to achieve herd immunity. Currently in the U.S., only about 6% of the population have received a full two-dose vaccine. That means that we still have quite a ways to go. In Kern County, about 105,000 doses of vaccine have been administered, but that only represents 11.7% of the population. So I really think we do have a lot to go. But now that some of the tiers are opening up a bit more, especially to food and ag workers and educators and childcare workers, I think that this number will improve dramatically in the next couple of months.
Here in Kern County, more than 100,000 doses have been administered. That does not translate to people because obviously some people have only received one dose, some have received two. But the good news is that we're getting shots out. At what point do you think we're going to start to see the effects of people who are vaccinated and stopping transmit the virus?
Well, of course, it's hard to know until more people get vaccinated. And of course, the curve that we've been following now for quite a while may reflect a number of factors. Is this just the normal course of disease? Is this a curve that's shortened somewhat because of sanitizing, masking, and distancing? And of course, to what extent have the individuals who've been vaccinated impacted the descent of that curve. I think it's so difficult to say which or all of those things have played a role. So we'll just have to see when more people get vaccinated, the right. overall effect of the vaccine.
Well, and next week or later this week, we're going to hear more about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which is something we're going to talk about on Thursday when you join us once again, because that is going to be in front of the FDA coming up. So that could be a game changer, as you said before. So we'll talk more about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine on Thursday. But for now, Dr. Goldis, as always, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.